the next for sure, what is going to happen, about what you can expect for the next few months. So I'm going to share my screen, and I think we can start the recording. Ah, but it's already recording, okay, hi. Okay. Let me... All right. Okay, so very briefly, what you can expect of the SDK for the next few months next year. So basically, you know that right now we are in the 1.3 version, and we are going to have the next SDK release next month, okay, in April, probably around the 10th or 15th of April, mid-April. So what we're going to have is in the 1.4, for example, in the new release, is more features regarding local analytics. Okay, this was one of the most demanded features for the community, like being the Android app to be able to render charts, tables, and well, maps already rendering maps. Okay, for the next versions. And this is going to be possible in the next Android release 2.4 and the next SDK release. So in the SDK, as you know, now after this workshop, you can like get the calculation from program indicators, okay? But now we can also, the SDK is going to give you also information about how we can like draw the different layouts for rendering charts or for rendering tables, okay? This is going to be ready in 1.4, again, in April 2021, at the TI instance scope, okay? So we are like just in the context of the tracked entity instances of the enrollment. And then calculations across TIs and events, and how we can render those calculations is going to be ready in 1.5. 1.5 probably is going to be published in October, November 20 of this year, okay? Also, in April, we are going to have dataset indicators with all the calculations. Right now, it's not possible, but this is going to be possible in the next coming release in a few weeks. What else? The utility method classes. This is a work that this has been already started like a couple of versions ago, but we are still like you know, adding more and more logic into these utility classes. Okay. For instance, we're planning to add more logic for validate data entry. That this can happen in the SDK. Ping services is the server that I need to post the data, post or get the data is active or is inactive, and other different kind of helpers. Okay. We're going to see more of the utility, how we can use utility classes and methods in the next workshop. Break the glass right now is not supported, and it's going to be supported in the next Android release in April. Working lists also it is not supported. I don't know if all of you know what a working list is, but basically it's a filter that you can define in the server, a filter about how you can render, for example, the malaria cases that hasn't been assigned yet, these kind of things. So basically, we can store all this information in SDK as well, so the app can render when listing the events or listing the TIs. Okay, we're going to have this ready also in the next Android release. Sorry, in the next one Android release, yes, and in the next SDK version. And then authentication, OpenID as well. This is going to be ready next month. Okay, for people that want to, for other organizations that instead of using the cookies authentication, if they want to use the OpenID. Then we still don't know when, but the multi-user multi-server, like giving the users the possibility of like, and also this one was quite demanded for the community as well, like you know, having a mobile that can be shared with different users, and every user will have their own like the access to setup. Okay, so right now it's not possible, but we plan to have this ready at some point at the end of this year or beginning of 2022. Okay, and the same with the having separated contexts, and there is an important use case in the community that. There are some implementations, they have sometimes like two servers, one for the TIs, for all the tracked entity instance data, tracker data and events, and another for aggregated. Okay, but right now you need to like, you have one or you have the other in your device. So we hope in like next year we are going to be able to have like the same context of two different servers in the same database in the SDK. Okay, so then the user, it's possible for the user to change the servers without losing the data. Then also we plan to have like more widgets and visualizations that are in, instead of in the application, that are in the as a separate module in the SDK probably. So for example, their unit tree, and that then if we can have this in the SDK, so all the implementations, all the Android custom, other custom Android applications that are using the SDK can have the same more visual components. Okay, so that's a little bit the idea, because also there are some components that are more tricky to build than others, and normalization unit tree can be one example of this. Okay, so. Yeah, having these visual components, the value type forms, the rendering types, something that we're going to talk more about in the second workshop. All this is in the app, but we plan to move it probably by the end of the year or 2022 to the SDK as well. Metadata granular sync, as you have seen during the presentations, when you are like downloading the metadata, you are downloading all the metadata. Okay. You cannot specify in the SDK right now. It's not possible to specify, okay, I just want to, maybe I am only want to synchronize or to download just one particular program or one particular data set or one particular unit. So right now is you download everything that the user has access to or nothing, right? So we plan to have more granularity for metadata synchronizations. Okay, but probably this is going to be happening in 2022. And then the last one that we have here, the online offline. Okay, you know that one of the main reasons of having the SDK is because it contains a local database, so everything is being stored in the database, so the app can work offline all the time, right? But maybe you have one setup in, for example, you are working in a hospital that has an intranet there. So you really don't need to wait 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 1 hour for the synchronization to happen. And even you don't need to store maybe nothing in your local storage. Okay, so in this case, maybe it's enough that the app will come work online completely. Okay. So also this is something that we believe is really cool. We plan to have this, let's hope, by the end of 2022. Okay, I don't know if you have any questions. We are a bit above time, so if not, I will move to the next, the last presentation, that is what is going to happen now. What is next? So is there any question? Okay, if not. Let me then. Okay, this is going to be just 5 minutes, I promise. The second workshop, okay. So this workshop was just an introduction. I know that some of you already know already the SDK, but others of you, this is the first time that you can see this working. So in the second workshop, we are going to go more deeper in the many topics that we have discussed during this workshop. And talking and also presenting new topics as well, like the analytics module that we plan to have next month. this is going to happen in May, between the 4th and the 7th. Okay, it's going to be 4 days, 3 hours, probably between three or four hours every day online, of course. Unfortunately, we cannot travel this year so far. And the objective is really to be a professional of the access to Android developer, okay, being a professional, but using the SDK. Okay, so you know that it's going to be, we are going to have a project, okay, and if you want to finalize the workshop, the second workshop, we are going to give you a certificate, but to give you a certificate, you need to finalize a project, okay. The timeline for the project is still TBD, to be discussed, but probably is going to be the first day of June, okay, more or less the first week, first day of June, okay. So you can start thinking of the project now if you like. We are going to give you some proposals, some ideas, okay, but basically here you have two options. So you propose what you want to do, okay, because you may be working for an organization or and maybe your organizations, they are like asking you for an Android application based on the access to, or maybe you have your own idea, your own, you say, okay, I have really this idea that I think is brilliant and I would like to implement this in an Android application, okay? That's the way that we recommend it, okay? And the only thing that we are going to ask you is just before, like starting the coding, just contact us because we can guide you with the and say, okay, but this is too much, this is going to be too complicated, or maybe the other way around, that I don't think is going to happen, but maybe no, you need to add more complexity here, okay? So in this option, if you would like to you can propose whatever you want to do, but you have to let us know, okay, in Slack, or we have Slack channels for Android. It's fine, or we can reach you in email as well. Okay. The other option is like you can take one of our project proposals, but you know it's like not completely defined. It's just to give you some ideas, something that you can do, and you can then you need to elaborate more and add maybe some more complexity there. Okay, but it's also possible that we are going to give you now like 3 or 4 proposals. The best project will be presented in the annual conference. Okay, which I think is really interesting for you. So yeah, we really encourage you to do this. Okay, the project. But again, this is a mandatory if you want to get a certificate. But if you are not interested in a certificate, you don't need to do it. In any case, please, because we need to, the Android team, the dev team, we need to really plan our time. And see how many projects and how many developers are going to submit a project. So please register here. Okay, I know that some of you has already done that like a month ago, but please do it again. Okay, so if you can do it like now or after finishing this session, the better. Okay, and because we are only going to take into consideration the people that has been registered in this form. And last thing, but important, I think this is obvious, that using the SDK in the project is mandatory. Okay, we are not going to pass or to evaluate like any Android application that is not using the SDK. Okay, it doesn't make sense. All these sessions are about using the SDK. Is there any questions regarding this? Okay.
Sorry, just to add that I posted the link in the chat on Zoom, so participants can just click on the link and register if they want to take part in the project.
Okay. Okay. Please do it as soon as possible. Like after this session, that will be perfect time. Okay. Some ideas, but again, we are encouraged to use your ideas. Okay, but if you are in blank and you don't have and you don't know what to do, well, you have time to think what to do, but we can give you some ideas, like for example, like building a metadata dictionary, like an Android application that is a metadata dictionary, right? So in this case, we'll only work with metadata, And so it will only download the metadata. And then in the Android application, you need to use the data layer in order to, for example, to list the programs or data sets and letting the user to ordering them by display name or last update. For example, if the user clicks on a program, you can list there the different program stages that a program may have, or if it is a data set, the different data set sections. Okay, if you open a program stage, you can list a data you can list the data elements that belong to the program stage. And whenever you, for example, you select a data element or select a program, you can also show up the description or the most relevant information about this particular piece of metadata. Okay. This is quite open. It just gives you some ideas of something that you can do. Okay. And actually something that the Android application is not currently doing. So I think this can be interesting also, you know, if you want to promote your application, your Android application to in the community as well. Okay, like other ideas, like hopefully you already have been played a little bit with the Android application, and you know that when you are entering data in an event, when you are entering events, it displays the all the fields of the events like a list, right? What we are proposing here is like you can change the visualizations, change the layout, and maybe give the users the possibility of entering the events following a tabular layout. Like for example, as we are doing with the aggregated values. Okay, in aggregated, you know that you need to add information. All the values are displayed in a tabular layout. Okay. For this one, we maybe recommend to use a tablet because it's going to be more user-friendly in terms of visualizations. And then one thing that you need to do is also the data needs to be uploaded and uploaded to front and to the server, okay? And maybe other idea, the last one, like, you know, showing data value changes in a table, okay? For example, you may have like in a tracker program, you may have like a repeatable program stages, okay? That you know that means that you can create like an event, well, several events for the same program stages, okay? So you will have, of course, the same data elements, and then you will actually analyze what are those changes in a table format, right? So you may have like a table, and every row of a table can be an event, for instance, and then you can see how the data is like evolving over time. Okay, and for that you can like use the new module that is going to be exposed in the SDK in the for the new version 1 for next month. This is just some ideas. As you see, it's quite open, but we encourage you to start thinking of this. So if you want to do it, fill the form, please. And then think of some ideas and then just let us know in Slack. Okay, Victor or Marcos or Luis, I have this idea, or Jose, I have this idea. What do you think? Do you think is appropriate for the project? Yes or no? And we are more than happy to help you with this process, okay? And I think that's all from me. I don't know, any questions regarding this?